Tenemos con nosotros al doctor Héctor Labruña de la Universidad de Cornell. Buenos días, Héctor.
Muy buenos días, ¿cómo estamos?
Un gusto tenerte en Casa Pueblo. Para nosotros es una alegría volverte a ver.
This is a collaborative effort with Cornell University, both the Department of Chemistry and Chemical Biology and the Cornell Center for Materials Research, along with the Río Piedras campus of the University of Puerto Rico, and of course Casa Pueblo here in Adjuntas.
Tenemos un proyecto que se llama el Instituto Comunitario de Biodiversidad y Cultura, donde ofrecemos cursos de autogestión comunitaria y de ecología a estudiantes de la Escuela Washington Irving de Adjuntas. Y eso nos ha permitido realizar unas alianzas con las universidades, como la Universidad de Puerto Rico, recinto de Mayagüez.
Más área superficial, muy bien. Por lo tanto,
we took advantage of the presence of Casa Pueblo, where they have already part of the infrastructure necessary to reach young children at an early age, with the intent of stimulating or bringing out that young scientist that resides in every children's heart.
Estos talleres que vienen brindando en colaboración bajo con un acuerdo entre la National Science Foundation, la Universidad de Cornell y Casa Pueblo, viene a ser un punto de partida bien importante, porque estamos conectando la ciencia, la cultura y una comunidad estudiantil, donde la ciencia viene a ser una herramienta fundamental.
¿Seguido de quién? ¿Del yeso?
One of the primary challenges is there are not many underrepresented groups in higher levels of math and science. So working with University of Puerto Rico as well as Cornell University, we bring these two groups of scientists together, collaborating with other schools, other teachers, other faculty, and we come to these communities as well to show that anyone can become a scientist.
La nena lo que hacía era que absorbía el agua y no sé que permitiera que fluyera el agua como él.
¿Y cómo las pusiste, mezclada o en capa?
Science is the way of looking at the world, solving problems and asking questions, and that's applicable to everyone.
¿Quiénes tienen celulares? Pues esas pantallas son de cristales líquidos. ¿Quiénes?
We've been encouraged not only by the very broad number of students that we were able to reach, but the broad age ranges. So we've looked at students from fourth grade all the way to eighth grade, and we've been able to reach in the neighborhood of 80 students, which for a two-day stay is truly extraordinary.
Y los cristales líquidos responden a cambios en temperatura y en luz. Y eso está relacionado a lo que vamos a hacer hoy.
The long-term impact of this, I hope, will be that they have an interest in science, either that they actually study science and become scientists in the future, or if they don't become scientists, which is fine, that they get an appreciation for science and know that there is value to what we do.
Y van a empezar a medir la temperatura y van a apuntar cuando esto cambia de color.
This is just a two-way process where you learn from the student, but the students learn from you, and that's a very awesome way of transmitting knowledge.
Tenemos que abrirles las puertas de decirles de que todo esto está disponible para que ellos puedan crecer y luchar por las metas que ellos se propongan en su futuro.
I think the long-term impact or the long-term strategy is how to bring educators and scientists together, and bringing these two separate communities together creates a whole new opportunity for them to develop activities that can be done in the classroom.
Eso ha sido un proyecto grandísimo porque le ha dado la oportunidad a nuestros estudiantes poder tener esa relación de educación científica con una prestigiosa universidad de Estados Unidos, donde los profesores ahora vienen a convertirse más allá de profesores, sino en actores de un proceso de transformación social.
I think back to when I was in fifth grade and sixth grade, and I had wonderful teachers who taught me about the scientific method and taught me about these great subjects and really inspired me for a lifetime. And I hope that I can give that back to people in Puerto Rico, people in Ithaca, my graduate students, undergraduates, really anyone that I come in contact with, I hope that I can pass some of that on to them.
Vamos a mover el plato y vamos a sacar la muestra. Aquí. El cambio de color es este que tienen aquí. So, van a marcar aquí.
Pregúntale.
Y más o menos la temperatura.
If one looks at sort of the research enterprise, broadly speaking, it is my firm belief that what has the most enduring power is the individuals that we reach, especially at a young age, because those will be the scientists of the future who will in turn train the scientists of future generations to come.